Hey folks, it's Lindsey Hellison back in the building. SPS, that is, over at North Farmington High School. We're over at the Holiday Extravaganza. Talking about basketball, but got a low-key celebrity in the building. When I walked over here, I started seeing these flashing lights and the paparazzi, and I said, what's going on? And they're like, you don't know who that is? Having Miss Nona Waldron, am I saying your name correctly?
Yes.
Get it right. She was like, you don't know who that is? No, she didn't say it like that. But I know that you are a track star, and that may be an understatement, breaking records everywhere you go. See, I did my research already. Why don't you introduce yourself to me, but let everybody else know as well who Nona is.
Okay, hello, I'm Nona Waldron. I attend Oak Park High School. I'm a junior, so class of 2023. I'm 16. I started running track 2 years ago. This is my third year. And I do both the 100 and 400 or 300 hurdles. Yeah, I'm the state champion in both hurdles, in both indoor and outdoor. Yeah, that's a lot.
I mean, gee whiz. I mean, enough's been said, but you've only been running for 2 years?
Yeah.
How did that happen that, you know, you got people who've been running since they've been this big, and in 2 years you come in and just take over like that?
I don't know. Well, my mother, she ran track. And before track, I was, like, big on cheer and gymnastics.
Uh-huh.
And she was like, no, like, you're done with that. Like, so she forced me to do
What's
track.
What's your mom's name?
Naia.
Naia. Shout out to Naia. Okay. So you got into it, and you love it, and you've been having a lot of success. So junior year is here. You're getting ready to get into the indoor season right now?
Yeah, we're... Indoor just started.
It just started. So what's your expectation for this indoor season?
Well, I'm U.S. number one in my hurdle event, so I have big expectations. I plan on, my second meet, I just PR'd in both my hurdles and the Open 400.
So personal record for those who don't know, right? Uh-huh.
Yeah. So if you're saying what times I plan on doing, like, I plan on going low eights in the hurdles, which is, like, really good for a hurdler.
Sure.
And I plan on winning nationals, 60 hurdles, both.
I love the language. My work is also in sports psychology. So talk about what it means for you to set a goal for yourself and to continue to work towards it no matter what's going on around you. And I know you've had some challenging things you've overcome in the recent months, and my heart goes out to you for that. But talk about how you remain focused to hit those goals.
Well, personally, I'm a very goal-oriented person. So when I make a goal, I achieve it. Like, I've never made a goal and not achieved it.
Mm.
And, like, no cocky anything, but, like, I'm just, like, I have to get it. You know, I don't stop until I get to my goal. And personally, me and my dad had, like, big goals set for myself.
Tell me your dad's name.
Troy. His name is Troy. So, like, it's just so much, like, it's personal. You know what I mean? Like, last summer was personal. Like, I had to accomplish my goals because that was me and his goals. Like, this year to win nationals and break the high school record in the season hurdles and all of that, that's, like, it's just, like, I got to do it. So, like, every day I go to practice, I think about my goal. So, yeah. I mean, if you say how do I accomplish my goals, I would say I put in extra work on my own.
Okay.
You know, I work inside and outside of practice, and I don't take practice lightly. Like, you know, some people go to practice and they play and they laugh and stuff.
Sure.
No, not me. Like, you can ask anybody. I'm, like, a different person when it comes to, like, practice and meets. Like, I don't play. I don't really talk. Like, I'm just, like, laser focused. Like, I really have something to do. You know what I mean? Like, it's like a job for me. So, yeah.
Well, that's awesome to hear, and I'm sure people are going to be able to take some good things from us. So let me ask you this. What advice can you give someone when it comes down to dealing with some serious adversity in your life, dealing with a tragedy? What kind of advice can you give them to be able to get through that and still reach those goals with all those other things going on?
Well, some advice I would give to you or anyone who's going through anything similar to my situation is to stay focused. Like, no matter what's going on around you, keep your goal, like, in mind. Like, don't change your goal and don't change the way you work towards your goal because of what's going on. Like, I don't know. Personally, Jack,
I
separated.
Right now, you're speaking to me. That's from a personal standpoint. I'm hearing what you're saying, but please go ahead.
Yeah, like you have to be like, I don't know. You should use whatever tragedy in your life as like to fuel you, like in whatever your craft is, say, like, for people who run track, like, if your parent just died or whatever, or, like, your parent's going through something, or you going through a lot of stuff at school, like, use that as, like, fuel. Like, you know what I mean?
You 16 or 36? How old are you?
16.
Oh, my goodness. That's serious. Use it as fuel to help you. That's You've done a great job. I'm glad you blessed me. Actually, this is not her first time being on the SBS Ed show. She was in the background a couple weeks ago, whatever, when I was doing our thing. But I appreciate that. Anybody you want to shout out before we let you go?
No. Shout out to my coach Brandon A. and my teammates. Shout out to y'all, too.
Yeah, you got that in there. This was Lindsay Hall from SBS. Hey, you got some great advice right here. I want to wish you all the best of luck. We'll see you guys next time. Peace.
See you.